Hey there, this is Ed Beard again with the Employer's Edge. And I thought it might be helpful to dive into the behavior of manageability so that in the hiring process, you actually look for that. And we call it looking under the hood, hiring for manageability. Because on the outside, you know, the car could look great, like most cars do. However, it's what's underneath the hood is what's going to leave you stranded and cost you a lot of money and just kind of get you really frustrated at exactly the wrong time. So you need to look under the hood of a person on the behavior of manageability. So what manageability is how someone approaches authority, processes, and rules. It is a conversation that very few people actually explore in the interview, and why it is so critical is because we get called in a lot 2 years after the organization has hired somebody on how that person is really interrupting relationships. They're really causing conflict in relationships because of their manageability behaviors. Well, if it's going to cause problems 2 years down the road, make sure you understand what you're getting at the hiring time by asking the right hiring questions on the subject of manageability. Folks that are high on manageability, the process and the rules and the authority structure is very important to them. The result is critical too, yes, but the process is just as critical as the rule as the results. Folks on the left side, on the lower side of manageability, and we assess for this, they're all about the results however they need to get them. So you have to give them a little leeway on how they go about getting results. Well, that's not always a good idea in safety situations or compliance situations. You don't always want to give people leeway on how they are compliant with things. Sometimes the processes keep people safe and actually get the result you want. Well, here's the thing. If you have a high manageability boss who is all about the rules and process and has a direct report who just does things their own way and they just go get the result their own way, the boss tends to think, well, I put that process in place for a reason. What do you think I am, stupid? And that's how it lands with the boss. It doesn't land as creative new way of doing things. It lands as you are being very disrespectful, low manageability person. Low manageability people, they're not all about the authority. If their boss isn't available, sometimes they'll go right to the boss's boss. They'll jump over to IT. They'll go wherever they got to get the result because the process doesn't matter. The escalation norm doesn't matter. The communication cross-department protocol, that doesn't matter. Their job is to get the job done. Well, they ruffle a lot of feathers in the process of getting it done. The beauty of being on the low manageability side is they come up with creative new ways of doing things that, you know, are actually sometimes pretty darn good. They just have to set up recognition of the current process before going into their own process. Well, if you have candidates you're looking to hire, few people explore the topic of manageability. Few people dive into how do you approach your day and going out processes and authority because it's automatically assumed. You have a boss, you report to them, you do what they want. Well, low manageability people don't always look at it that way. So you need to assess for manageability. It is a primary source of why conflict happens in relationships, and you may as well find out the job fit a person has on their manageability behavior at the time you interview them and not let them get two years down the road and now you got a bigger problem to deal with. So assess for manageability. It's critical. I'm just telling you it's critical. And I hope that helps your hiring process.